it was important to record the London Symphony Orchestra and the London Symphony Choir live on the day. And that was something we talked about for years. How are we going to do this? You know, what is the best process to do it?
I mean, there were already stories in existence that it's like a nightmare to record in there. You know, the acoustics, it's just this terrible cavern. I mean, it's beautiful, but it was not easy to get a good recording in 73.
We asked Classic Sound to come in and help us, you know, rig up this 600-year-old cathedral. And we brought in our own Dolby Atmos mics and some of our own kind of specialty microphones that we like to use to capture the ambience. We were able to have a couple of the period mics in frame for the opera singers and also for the choir. We had mics on stands. It's hard to see in the film, but they're there. And we were able to pull off that recording. The goal was always to put the audience in the middle of the orchestra, to let them hear an orchestra and a choir that big with that much power the same way that Lenny would hear it.
Performance itself was captured with so many microphones that it gave you the complete three-dimensional sense of that space and of the feeling of that music in that space. And Tom Ozanich, music and mixer, did a wonderful job of combining all those mics, creating a three-dimensional sense of the music in a cathedral.
The camera moves over players, or we turn and we focus on the choir. Those things have to move into place and play their part, bump up to the excitement level that they're supposed to be to feature that thing. And then all that reverb and space is at least 90%, if not more of that, is actually in the track of the room of Ely Cathedral.
I'm thrilled that we did pull it off and we didn't have to go back and post-record. And it was captured in a way on set that it could go through a pre-mix process and come to the dub stage with Tom and Dean and immerse itself in Atmos and then really deliver the power the scene has.
You can do anything in Atmos and place things where you want, but Tom is the one who placed certain sections of that orchestra, the choir, either up in the ceiling and on the sides. And it's pretty great, and you don't notice it, but you hear it and you feel it. That's all done on the dub stage.
And there's not a single frame of this movie that we didn't pore over and look at every detail with Dean and I sitting there with Bradley in between us all the time and look at literally every single detail. And it all had to serve the purpose of the story of that marriage and be true to them and to Lenny's music.
Hopefully people will see all the hard work that has gone into it and how seamless it is. I hope it revives younger audiences to listen to this music and take an interest in it. This movie is a beautiful love story.